Fitness from the BBC World Service. And today, we're taking you back to the Greek capital Athens, nearly 40 years ago, to remember the ruthless crushing of a student protest by the country's military regime.
It is November 1973, and Greece is under a military government. This is what's known as the regime of the colonels. They've been in control now for 6 years after seizing power in a coup. They dissolved parliament and ruled the country in a deeply repressive, dictatorial style. Maria Damanaki is a student and political activist.
Well, the political leadership of the country, and mainly the leadership of the left side, were imprisoned or exiled. And there was this silence, the silence that is connected with fear. Nobody talked a lot, and no newspapers for a while, and afterwards newspapers completely controlled by the military junta. The people, they didn't react a lot. They discussed it, but, well, there was fear.
But Maria Damanaki and other young activists had decided that it was time to stand up. They began a sit-in protest on the campus of the Polytechnic in the center of Athens and started thinking about how best to organize their meager resources.
Our central slogan was bread, education, and freedom. Then some young students came to me and they told me that, look, we are engineers, or at least we are trying to be, so we can have a radio station here and broadcast our signal set to the whole area of Athens and Attica. So we have done it, and it was something that changed Greek history and our lives, of course, forever.
With their makeshift radio station, they were reaching beyond the student community. They were getting their increasingly strident anti-junta message out to the whole of Athens in what amounted to an extraordinary challenge to the government. And Maria Damanaki and her fellow activists could sense the wider population beginning to rally behind them.
On Thursday morning, it was a big demonstration around the Polytechnic School, a lot of people, and we were very happy, I can say. We think that we have succeeded. Suddenly, it was not only the students there, but also adults, younger people, workers, a lot of people. It was really an event, and the military junta realized that there was a real uprising going on. We had an uprising, and this was something they could not ignore anymore.
And as their cause gathered momentum, the students set their uprising to music. Their radio station was airing the songs of the popular dissident musician Mikis Theodorakis. He'd been jailed and then exiled by the regime, which had banned the playing of his work.
Even the music, even listening to this music was a kind of a reaction against the junta. And we had this music, we had these ideas, and we called people to come with us and give us help. And so a lot of people came and gave us food and gave us support. Well, they didn't stay a lot, I can say, because they were afraid, but well, it was a real uprising. Thousands of people around the Polytechnic School.
And did you fear that there might be real violence to end this thing from the military side?
On Friday morning, we have realized that there were some shooters around the Polytechnic School, and we heard the first gunshots.
Military snipers?
Military snipers, yes. And we had the first dead people and the first injured people, so we organized. Well, I cannot say that it was a hospital, but it was a smaller room trying to give them a medical help. And during the night, we have been informed that the tanks, the military tanks, are coming. We can hear the noises. So we have changed again our messages from the radio. We were broadcasting for the soldiers. We are trying to persuade them not to shoot against us, were trying to persuade them that we are all together and not to obey to their instructions. But well, for them it was difficult, I can understand now. So after midnight, it was a real nightmare. The tank in front of the central gate of the Polytechnic School, they forced the gate, they get in.
They rammed the gate with
yes.
the tank?
Yes, with the tank, and they got in and they started shooting. So we have decided that we have to leave. The last thing which was broadcast was the national anthem, the Greek national anthem. All the people there, we were singing together. And afterwards we closed the radio station, we destroyed it. We had to destroy it because we were afraid that they are going to use it. We tried to kiss each other, say goodbye and try to leave. But it was very difficult to leave, as you can imagine, to leave the Polytechnic School because soldiers were around shooting. So I had to climb through the wall and then I had to jump and there were shootings. And, well, it was not pleasant, but after all I survived.
The protest had lasted just 3 days. One report suggested that 24 people had died when the military moved in. The exact number of casualties remains uncertain. Having been such a prominent figure in the events at the Polytechnic, Maria Damanaki was hunted down by the regime.
My life changed immediately because being run and hide all the time was not easy, and afterwards the prison and what comes with the prison, not only prison but a lot of other things with prison.
When you say other things?
I mean bad behavior and tortures, something like that. And afterwards... After this experience, I really loved life. Because when you go out of prison, for example, where it's dark and all these things, and you go to Santorini, I was very happy to go to Santorini. It's a Greek island with all this sun and this light. And you can see that life is very precious. And this is something I have with me throughout all my life.
The political repercussions of the Polytechnic uprising were profound. Within days, a hardline brigadier, Dimitrios Ioannidis, staged a coup, ousting his fellow officers who led the junta. The brigadier initially tried to tighten the military's control, but his regime would only last about 7 months. It collapsed after provoking an unsuccessful coup attempt in Cyprus, which led to a Turkish invasion of the island. But Maria Damanaki believes that it was events at the Polytechnic that marked the beginning of the end of military rule, severely undermining the junta at home and in the eyes of the world.
They thought that if they get tougher, it will be easier for them. But it was the beginning of their death, eh? Because getting tougher and tougher, the reaction became stronger and stronger. Eh? And this was exactly the beginning of their death.
With the collapse of military rule in July 1974, the army returned to its barracks and democracy was restored. The student activist Maria Damanaki was free to pursue a career in politics, first in Greece and then at the European level. And today, nearly 4 decades on, she is the European Union's Commissioner for Maritime Affairs and Fisheries.
Maria Damanaki spoke to Alan Johnston for Witness. For details of our